Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate, Siege of Dragonspear, Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. So I have to say, I'm really enjoying this so far. I'm pleasantly surprised. From things I've heard, I really thought it was either dreadful, dreadfully boring, or really just average. I'm really liking it so far, especially all the voiceovers. I enjoyed the, you know, first dungeon, the beginning of the game. And I'm really liking all the little quests here. I'm finding it quite nice. Of course, you know, time remains to tell if, you know, this level of quality keeps up, but I'm really enjoying it. So up to the second floor, finally, of the three old kegs.
A simple matter.
Oswald says, "A toast! A toast, my friends, to Ophyllis, without whose generosity we'd not be here." Well,
a simple matter.
I don't know where these people are. There's Ithtil. Because we'd not have been allowed back in here, Borali says. Maybe I should get my friends, who are supposedly on the third floor. Let me just check in here before I deal with these people. The cook? You're gonna tell us to get the hell out of here.
You have an unrefined palate.
Thank you, Gordon Ramsay. To cook a fantastic meal, you need absolute silence. Absolute silence. You see where I'm going with this?
It's always good to give a little tip.
I'm afraid I don't have time to talk. You're looking for a drink. One of the bartenders downstairs can help you. A few commoners. Hey, watch where you're going. Oh, read that one before. Hastus? Ozzel? Where's Ozzel? Oh, they're over here. Okay, I'm not gonna talk to them. Oh! They're talking to me. Oh, there, stranger. Come and have a drink with us. You seem in high spirits this morning, friends. Why shouldn't we be? We have a roof over our heads, food and drink, more than we've had since the Shining Lady's Bloody Crusade drove us from the Troll Claws. You arrived in town recently, then? No, we've been here a 10 day or more. Whoever said that, Ozzel says it's Duke Belt's charity that feeds us. Well, the charity of his palace's treasure, anyway. What was his name again? Ophidius? No, Ophyllis, that was it. He was the one that contributed to our merrymaking. I don't think I should confront them just yet. Hold on a second. Alright. I don't want to confront them just yet. It's funny you mention Ophyllis. I encountered him earlier. He did not have the air of one who happily parted with the gold you spend here with such abandon. Who are you? What do you want with us? Oh, boy. I don't have any chance. As soon as I walked over here... I am Sapphire, hero of Baldur's Gate. The gold you stole from Ophyllis belonged to me. I would like it back, and I would like justice for the innocent man you beat so viciously. We don't have the gold, Ozzel says. This banquet you enjoy is certainly impressive, but you could not have spent all my gold on it. Borali says, the journey to Baldur's Gate was long and hard, and our time here has been no easier. We're skin and bones. This is the first decent meal we've had in 2 months or more. Oh, cry me a river. Ozzel says, our story is hardly unique, I know. Thousands who fled the crusade huddled in the streets of this city, cold, hungry, and alone. We took the treasure as gold, not just to help ourselves, but others who share in our plight. I'm never getting this gold back, am I? You gave the rest of the gold to those who needed it. To those who desperately needed it. That gold saved many lives, or at least prolonged them a time. If you must be punished for that, so be it. I'll die gladly, knowing I did so in the service to a higher cause. I don't want you to die, I just want my gold back. Ozzel says, if we're not killed, a cell in the Flaming Fist will at least offer a roof over our head and a meal a day. That's more than many have right now. Well, if that is true, if I can even trust them, I might rather search their persons and their whatever room they're staying in, if they're staying in a room. But yeah, they did beat him. And stole money. Your heart might have been in the right place, but what about Ophyllis? You beat the man within an inch of his life. I cannot allow thievery and assault to go on unchallenged in the city. Go downstairs and turn yourself in to Captain Corwin of the Flaming Fist. You're right. We needed what we took, but that doesn't excuse what we did. We'll turn ourselves in. Farewell, hero. Really? I thought we were going to have some huge battle. It seems my gold is lost to me. I found the band of ruffians who robbed Ophyllis. They claimed to have taken my money in order to feed and shelter their fellow refugees. Though they had good intentions, I couldn't allow their illegal actions to go unchallenged. I convinced them to turn themselves into the Flaming Fist. Really? That's very surprising. Hastus appears busy. Hastus is making haste. Huh. I'd like to verify that they indeed talk to
me. I hope our establishment's to your liking.
Huh. That's certainly interesting. They've stuffed hundreds of those refugees in the Iron Throne building. I might put on some rags and hang around the building, see if I can get a free dinner. Brother. Are you single? Ha! I knew it. Not as far as you're concerned. The city still stands thanks to you, and doing better than ever. Your name will go down in history. You're a great woman. Well, they like me now. Okay, not anymore. Get out of our city. Baldur's Gate doesn't need another Saravak. I'm not a Saravak. Oh, I remember this thing. A black opal and a water opal. I can't carry it, and I don't think I can add anything. I need to come back here with friends. Upstairs we go. It'll be good to be reunited with Minsc and Dynaheir.
A simple matter.
There's Lord Maxwell, Lady Araya. Lord Maxwell says, there's no doubting it. Now is the time to remove the Council of Four and take the city for ourselves. Lady Araya says, hush, someone's here. Lord Theriton says, you there! This is a private room. What are you... You're Sapphire, aren't you? The hero of Baldur's Gate? What are you doing here? A better question is what you're doing here. Oh? Maxwell says. What precisely did you hear? things you really don't want to make their way to the Grand Duke's. Let's talk about how much you're ready to spend to make sure that doesn't happen, don't we? You can't intimidate me. I'll scream for the guards, Lothirton said. Please do. I'll need the guards here when I expose you as traitors. Maxwell says, for the love of the gods, Thirton, can't you see the murder in her eyes? Hand over everything you have. Here, take my dagger, too. And here's my cloak, Arya says. Please, just don't hurt us. I'm dropping things. We'll take our leave now. Never let us see your face again. Alright, 600 gold, 300 experience, boots, dagger, cloak. I uncovered a seditious plot and used it to my advantage. Meeting of the minds. I've extorted what I could from the traitorous nobles. They should learn to be more careful when they plot. Alright, so I dropped some stuff. I couldn't carry anything. Yeah, I don't have a space for that. I don't have room for anything. Let's see if this is even worth... Oh my! You got magical boots and a magical dagger. And a treasury note. Oh, it dropped. What did I... Oh, that's her cloak. It's a cloak of protection plus one. Alright. It took the cloak and dropped the letter. I need Minsc and Dynaheir. Can't we carry the stuff?
What is it, Boo? I've never seen you so.
Hey!
Ah, can it be? Is this the hero of Baldur's Gate I see?
It is I, Minsc. It's been too long. Actually, it hasn't been that long.
Boo's giant shrunken heart thrills to see you again, as does my own.
Giant shrunken heart.
How are you?
Worse now than I was a day ago. I'm journeying to the north. I'm hoping Boo, and you of course, would join me.
Boo and I would journey to at least 7 of the hells and back for you. Probably all 9, but Boo says, Minsc, be realistic. This, you know. But we cannot leave our friend Dynaheir undefended.
I wouldn't ask you to. I'm hoping she will come too.
Then do as the cats do to Boo when they think he is not looking and follow.
Minsc will only join me if Dynaheir does as well. That's fine with me. I met Minsc and his miniature giant space hamster Boo at the 3 Old Kegs. I must convince Dynaheir to join me on the trek to Dragonspear Castle if I wish to have Minsc at my side. Fine by me. Hello?
No more, my friend. I've enjoyed debating your hamster on the finer points of... who is this? Wait, I know thee. Yes?
Stop playing, Dynaheir. It's good to meet you again. What is it I can do for thee this morning? I'll be facing Kalar Argent, the Shining Lady, soon. Do you know anything of her?
I know of this woman. There are those who believe her to be a daughter of the divine, perhaps even a child of Baal. She merits further investigation and is the reason I still linger in the region. When dost thou leave?
You would join me?
We would. I must investigate this Kalar further.
Then ready your things and come with me.
Prepare yourself, Boo. We are about to embark on another epic adventure.
Minsc and Dynaheir have joined my company. Think if I chose the other thing to meet me, then they would have not joined my party at this point, but I would have had to meet them and then they would join, but I need them right now. Minsc and Dynaheir have joined my company. The Ranger Minsc and the Wicklaren he's sworn to guard, Dynaheir, have agreed to help me in my efforts to lay Kalar low. If I dismiss them, They will travel with the Flaming Fist to their camp at Coastway Crossing. Alright, I'm not going to dismiss them.
Aye!
Alright, so he's got some of his stuff, the things that were... Yeah, as I was thinking... I was right. The things that are... equipped. They kept. I'm assuming these are the same with the biographies. Can I?
Magic is impressive, but now Minsc leads. Swords for everyone! Yeah, let's talk more fight!
Here we go. More like it. Now, pick up some of this stuff for me. Treasury note, special boots, and a dagger. I'll take that back. Those are very colorful boots. Ostentatious boots. These iridescent scale boots gleam with 100 shades of color. On a trade voyage across the Alhambra Sea, a ship passed by a pitched battle between Sahagin, I'm saying that right, marauders and a colony of merfolk. The ship's bard leaned over the rail and played a rousing ballad of courage. Bolstered, the merfolk overcame and drove off the vicious Sahagin. One of the mermaids swam up to the ship and handed the bard a glittering shed mermaid tail, telling him that any item fashioned from the scales would gain a valuable enchantment. The bard had the tail made into a pair of boots that had been passed on to his descendants, though their flashy nature makes the wearer quite memorable. Charisma plus one. I might just sell those. Although she doesn't have boots. Might as well wear them, I guess. Helps her charisma. I think that might help with a save. Let's see, 10, 7, 9, 11, 8. No, it doesn't really help. She doesn't have any boots, so might as well have her wear them. Unless we need the money, which probably do. Oh, she already has it. It's just a dagger plus one. That we will sell. Alright, so we got stuff in here. Really? Got any stuff from here you'd like to bring with you? No. Delendra?
Simply no standards these days.
What are you doing in here? This is a private room. This is Minsc flirting. My deepest apologies. I heard there was a noblewoman here who might be interested in my anti-aging magic, but a beauty like yours needs no help from me. Anti-aging? I can cast spells to reduce the signs of aging, so you have little need of such things, except for, well, perhaps. Perhaps what? What is it? You have a few very fine lines, laugh lines I call them, around the corners of your eyes. I can get rid of them for a price. How much would such a service cost? I've laughed a lot in my life. Sure about that? Probably more like laughing at people. That necklace around your throat would be sufficient payment. My necklace? Well, I suppose it's worth it. Here you are. Here's a spell I promise, madam. When next you awake, your laugh lines will be gone. Because Minsc can cast a few spells. What? Get out. I've convinced a noblewoman to give me a valuable necklace. This is incredibly random. A vain noblewoman at the Three Old Kegs ordered me out of her room. I'd only entered by accident, but given her tone, I felt justified in profiting from the mistake. I tricked her out of the necklace with cunning words. Let's check this for books. History of the North 2. History of the Red Ravens. I've read those. I'm not going to go in this. Should probably call for the guards.
The Grand Dukes must do something about this.
And by the way, I can feel the magic working. Minsc, you devil. Ooh. History of the Vast. And History of the Dead 3. What do we... Oh, we just cast sparkly lights. Oh, boy.
What?
Yeah, let's get out of here. She's coming over to talk to us. Okay. Right, we want access to this. I couldn't pick that up. Another gem. Excellent.
Let's talk more fight.
Well, we got the party.
What?
Back together again. Well, half of us.
Trouble?
And you know what? We can actually rest here.
Let's talk more fight!
You are welcome here.
Wait, I can't sleep here?
Good day to you.
Ah, guess they're full. Well, I definitely need some rest.
Tis always good to give a little tip.
Damn, I thought we could rest.
Ah, it has been too long since Minsc journeyed with such a fine companion.
Find an inn or rest outside. I'm in the inn. All right.
Yes?
At least I have some capable companions here.
Let's talk more fight!
Alright, let's advance. Is our friend coming with us? Yes, she's here with us. Coming.
Please, help us.
Maybe the crusade will pass through the Troll Claw Hills and become Troll Dinner. I like the way you think.
I'm so tired.
Half my village was forced to flee. The other half was forced into the crusade.
I'm so tired.
Spare a gold piece for a refugee.
Can't hardly move in these streets.
The dark god stenches upon you. The rumors are true. Well, that's it for this area. Oh, that's the Ducal Palace. Elfsong Tavern. Flaming Fist. Let's go to the Elfsong Tavern and, who's at the Flaming Fist TX? Yeah, let's go to Elfsong.
Yes!
We aren't far from the Elfsong Tavern. A few people you might want to speak with, Safana, Koran, and the bard Garrick, have been seen there recently. Or if you'd like to get some supplies for the journey to Dragonspear, we can go to Sorcerer's Sundries.
I'm gonna go that last, even though we're right here.
An excellent day.
Once we have everybody. Looks like Zelma is coming to talk to us, maybe? Yep. Pardon me, I'm new in town. Can you tell me where to find Sorcerer's Sundries? Hey, get your hand out of my pocket. You're pretty sharp. So is my blade. Oh boy. All the way to the bank.
You want Boo?
Yes.
Actually, I'm going to switch back to bullets.
What?
I should hurry to the moneylender to deliver this purse. Took the money. A pickpocket targeted me, but I noticed her attempt and fought back. Alright. Huh? Someone called a flaming fist on these something or other. Just appeared out of nowhere.
Yes.
All right, 89 gold, studded leather, short sword. I'll leave that. That was interesting. There's a officer Vida over there. Out of my way, you rabble!
Order is what matters.
You lot just sit tight until backup arrives. You require assistance? What's going on here, officer? These refugees came to our city for aid, then repaid our generosity by causing a commotion in the street. Tanorum says, maybe we got a little rough with each other. What of it? Our tempers are short, and the hours pass slowly. Rabble rousers. You think you're the only one struggling right now? You should count yourself lucky you've not tasted Flaming Fist steel this morning. Officer Vida says, I haven't enough people to escort all these rowdies to headquarters. Could you go to the Flaming Fist command center and tell Jenks that Officer Vida needs reinforcements? Of course. I'm always happy to assist the city's defenders. Tanorum says, please, ask the Fist to show us mercy. We've lost our homes, our possessions, some of us our families to the crusade. Must we lose our freedom, too? Vida says, perhaps you'll appreciate freedom a little more after you spend a few days behind bars. Now still your red-blooding tongues before I steal them for you. All right, rabble-rousers. I should go to the Flaming Fist headquarters for reinforcements. Officer Vida of the Flaming Fist has a group of refugees detained outside Sorcerer's Sundries. She needs the Flaming Fist HQ to send reinforcements. Mm-hmm.
For Baldur's Gate.
What news, ma'am? Nothing yet. Let me know if that changes. Unconscious man.
Such crowds of tiny people. Make way for Minsc and Boo, tiny ones!
Well, can't talk to him. Conscious
We're
man.
More than mercenaries.
The Dukes can't leave the palace without getting mobbed. So where's this guy? Panorm is here.
I'm so tired.
You don't deserve this treatment. Alright, doesn't have much to say. Flaming fist, clear a path. Nothing in here. What is this? Elfsong Tavern. We just got here. They're not attacking you right now. Let's go into Elfsong Tavern.
Elfsong Tavern. A little pretentious for my taste. I'll wait for you here.
Who am I here to find again? A bard named Garrick. The why a bard would spend time here is beyond me. House rules discourage singing, at least by those of Garrick's ilk. There's also Safana and Coran, a pair of unsavory characters staying upstairs. Belt thinks might be of use. Why he'd think that, I don't know, but it's not my place to argue with a Grand Duke. Call if you need me.
Get away, you crazy craze makers! Get away!
He sounds funny. Recruitment drive. Household guard.
Sword fight! Clear yourself!
No singing. House rule. You heard him, Minsc.
Can't hardly move in these streets.
Blood will tell. You can't fight your nature. The rumors about you are all true, I say. Too much rain this year. Not enough rain last year. Gods must be annoyed with us again. Been saving my gold for a special treat. Heading to the Three Old Kegs tonight for a tankard of mead. I talked to that one. I know what you did for Nashkel. You have my thanks. You're a twisted sword, aren't you? I can tell just by looking
at
you.
Speak to me, visions. Like, totally guide me.
Saravak lives and you're a stooge. I have proof. Alright, who's speaking over here?
What? Fine.
Zaviak?
Whoa. Whoa.
Whoa?
Oh, man. Are you in the sewers, too?
This is a tavern.
I mean, I know it's a tavern, but who put it here? So weird.
You think someone put a tavern in the sewers?
Ah! Whoa! Sorry. That one came right at my face. Yeah, so we're in the sewers, right? Underwater deep.
You're not even in the right city.
No, man. You're way off. I came down into the sewers as part of my vision quest.
Okay.
I just didn't, you know, expect to, like, see so much.
What exactly are you seeing?
Ah! Yikes! It's these new glasses, man. They're supposed to let me see, like, who I really am. Like, inside my soul.
Where did you get these glasses?
I got them from that giant gnome with the scales. It crashed on his couch last time I was in Sigil.
You've been to Sigil? I thought it was Sigil. That's the city in Planescape.
But all I see is invisible monsters and ghosts and stuff. It's making me feel, like, really surrounded, you know? By my surroundings.
So these enchanted spectacles let you see invisible creatures?
I'm starting to freak out, man.
Let me take a look at them, man.
Whoa. That's, like, profound, man. You're blowing my mind. Here, take him.
Thanks, man.
Everything's so much clearer now. Maybe you're the one who should be on a vision quest. I'm laying off for a while.
We got spectacles of spectacle? Yeah, just chill out for a bit.
Oh, and the giant gnome said the glasses can, like, pull spirits into reality a few times. So be careful. You don't want to drag a screaming Modron or Gith into the Prime for a hangout.
Well, I'd love to bring Nordom. Or, what's his name? Oh my god, I can't believe I forget people's names. The Getzerai? The hell is his name? I'm looking it up now because I hate when I can't remember names. I guess that was pronounced Sigil. Dakan. Okay. How you survived this long, I have no idea.
Later, man.
Laters. Xaviak's vision quest. If I wear the spectacles of spectacle, I can see extraplanar creatures and pull up to three of them into this world. Oh, like summon them? Will they fight for me? That'd be awesome. I obtained a pair of magical spectacles from the eccentric elf Xaviak. Sure didn't sound like an elf. He claims I can use them to see spirits and creatures from other planes and pull these creatures into our world a finite number of times, so it has charges. I have no idea how many of these extraplanar creatures I'll see on my journey. I must think carefully before drawing one into the prime material plane. Yeah?
Oh, hey, man. How's it going?
I had a question about these spectacles.
You're all right, man. What can I do for you?
What exactly will I be looking at when I put on these spectacles?
All right, so, like, our plane overlaps with all these other planes, right?
Right.
Overlaps isn't really the right word. It's more like circles. In other circles? It's complicated. Anyway, the other planes have creatures on them overlapping us. That's what you see.
And you said I could pull creatures into this plane?
Yeah, like, our reality is called the Prime Material Plane, and the other planes have other names. You can pull a creature from its plane to ours, but they might not like it, man. Think about it, you know? Fish out of water, you know? Only maybe less with the fish dying and more them, like, killing you. Or not.
Alright, so apparently I can summon these things. One way to look at it, but they may or may not cooperate. What exactly do these spectacles reveal?
All right, so, like, our plane overlaps later.
There are other options, though.
Oh, hey, man. How's it going?
You know, I'm not a man, right? And that's a figure of speech.
Man doesn't mean, like, man, man. It means, like, dude.
Well, that clears that up.
You're all right, man. What can I do for you? Later.
I just want to see this.
Oh, hey, man. How's it going?
It's going, man. It's going.
You're all right, man. Later.
All right, let's take a look at these. Only 3 charges. Look at that. A gnome wizard named Peravior found the constraints of the prime material plane too boring, quote-unquote, and committed himself to visiting every plane of existence that he could uncover. Peravior crafted these spectacles in order to see and interrogate beings from other planes, hoping in this way to find safe places in which to shift onto other planes. After speaking at length with a very pleasant and well-mannered devil, Peravior followed the fiend's instructions for visiting Phlegathos, oh wow, hell of a name, only to disappear with an anguished scream into a column of living flame. All that remained behind was a smoking pair of spectacles. Okay, detect illusion plus 25%, savers illusion spells plus 3, charge abilities pull an extra planar creature into the prime. Doesn't say it's summoning. And this goes as a helmet, which I'm not wearing, but so that's fine. Okay. Oh, I'm seeing one of them, aren't I? If I talk to it, am I pulling it in? Through the spectacles of spectacle, you catch sight of an otherworldly creature. Oh boy. Well, I'm going to save that for next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.